Welcome to our fitness podcast. In this podcast, we are going to debunk some of the myths in fitness. We are going to give you ideas and some of the motivation so that you can continue with your fitness. Coach,
yes.
Thank you so much for coming. Kindly, what inspired you to start your fitness journey?
Okay. Before I started my fitness journey, I used to admire my fellow in secondary, my fellow colleague playing rugby. So I joined the team. In our school, we had a gym. So that's when I started my fitness journey.
Oh, sure. You played rugby
in
school?
Yes, I did play rugby in secondary school.
Ah, great, great. Yes.
I did play rugby. And not really rugby that really inspired me to start my fitness journey.
Okay, okay.
But also, I had a friend who had a home gym.
Okay.
He used to work out every morning. Every morning I used to see him with biceps, good bicep, good triceps. So I wanted to be like him.
Okay.
So his name was Mike. He used to inspire me to also start my fitness journey.
Ah, fair enough. I thought maybe you wanted to have some good body, like
yes, good
shape,
the
six pack, biceps.
Course,
so you see now, so some, you know, some external fact like ladies, you know, when girls in school, when they see you, they
I wanted to look good. I wanted to have those girls. Of course, what motivated me to want to start my fitness goal was I wanted to have girls.
You wanted to have, that's fair enough.
Because I wanted to have a good body, you know, so that I can have a girl I want in secondary school.
You know, boys are just boys. Because you know, I will be surprised if you are not going to mention that girls were also a motivation for you to start.
Something that also motivates me.
Yeah. And that's okay. Some of people have seen maybe for security reasons, you know, when you're being harassed and bullied in school by those ahead of you. So some people want just to be strong so that you can protect yourself and all that.
See, I was the youngest in secondary school. I wanted to look big. I wanted to match
those who are ahead of you so that
I wanted to look a bit big.
Yeah.
Not really for fighting, but I just wanted to look big.
Yeah, you know, that's enough security because, you know, once someone looks at you, they just get scared. No one is going to bully you and all that.
So that's what motivated me.
Let's move to the next aspect. So how do you stay motivated to remain consistent with the fitness routine?
First of all, I have a very supportive girlfriend.
Okay.
Who always reminds me that anytime I'm starting to lose mass or I'm being unfit, it reminds me that I'm supposed to go to the gym.
Oh, your girl works out?
Yeah, he does. She does work out.
Oh, okay, okay. Yeah. Fair enough.
She's the first person who always supports me.
Okay.
Wherever I don't feel like going to the gym, wherever he's there, remind me that I'm supposed to be in the gym.
And that's nice.
And also, the second one, I'm a coach.
A fitness
and
coach.
And being a coach, you must be fit. So I always remind myself that because I'm a coach, I have to be fitter than
your clients.
Exactly.
Yeah, because
so that they can see whatever I'm telling them to do, I've also done it.
Yeah, sure. You know, as a fitness coach, you are a role model to your client.
Exactly.
You know, there's no way you're going to tell your client this is how to get a flat tummy and all that, and then you are protruding belly, so you know it doesn't sound right.
So my work. Because of my work, I have to stay in fitness level, maintain my clients. My clients will always look at my body and they judge me whether I'm a coach or not.
Yeah, so they'll be able to judge the type of workout you are giving them, whether it's going to work. Because, you know, if you tell them to do like 50 sit-ups, but for you, you know, very big tummy and all that, so they can't really trust what you're trying to tell them. But it is fair enough, you know, as a role model, you have to maintain that figure. Yeah, that's a very good motivation to keep you remaining consistent. How do you balance your fitness goals and other aspects of life like work and family commitments?
Okay, for me, my priority is work. My work is already fitness.
Okay.
So work comes first.
Okay.
So it means fitness comes first. So for me, family is not a big issue because they also understand that where the money is coming, the finances, is from my work. What is my work? My work is fitness. So yeah. I don't have a lot of challenges in balancing my work with family, because they know if I'm not at home, whether I'm not in the family,
you are at
the
work,
gym, or I'm attending to a certain client. So I have no problem with balancing my work and family.
So the balancing has been easy.
It has been easy because, you know, this is my passion. This is my work.
By the way, I remember you said your girlfriend works out. You know, that's fair enough. Of course, she understands what it takes to train clients and all that. I think that's okay. And then another thing, the best thing for you, already you are a fitness coach, so your work is fitness. You know, but you know, you have these people, for example, you have clients who come to the gym, they want to work out, but during the day, they are going elsewhere. Maybe they are teachers, doctors, they are accountants, you understand? So, you know, for them, maybe there's some challenge because creating time. You know, some people, maybe they are not, people wakes up, they don't wake up early in the morning. So in the morning, they just want to wake up, go to the work, then come in the evening. So in the evening, there are other challenges, maybe you getting from office late and all that. So for you, it is a different case.
Okay, for me, I usually advise my clients that fitness is a lifestyle.
It's not about
creating time. You must have time.
You must have time for fitness.
It's like you're taking tea in the morning. You always have
wake
time.
Up, you know it. You have to take
so
tea.
If you're into fitness, you must just have time. It's not a matter of creating time.
Okay.
Yeah. Time must just be there. Like you only need like 30 minutes to 45 minutes.
Yes, of some moderate to high intensity workout.
45 minutes is enough for me.
Yeah. So you don't have to take like 2 hours or 3 hours.
No, don't take 2 hours.
Not unless you are a professional bodybuilder, I see. Exactly. But for someone who are doing it for the as a lifestyle thing, you need like 30, 40 minutes of moderate to high intensity. Especially if you have a coach, you have a trainer, a personal trainer.
Yes.
They can easily guide you. And within 30 minutes, you are done with your workouts, then you go back home.
Yeah, exactly. Especially, I want just to advise those who usually say, I don't have time to go to the gym, I wake up in the morning, ready to go to work, I come very late. No.
Okay.
That's not an excuse for you not to go to the gym.
To the gym,
to
fit. Yeah.
You must have that 30 to 45 minutes.
Okay.
And for you to balance that time, get a personal trainer. If you get a personal trainer, you are paying that trainer. You'll want to get the value for your
value for your money. So,
it means you will create that time. Of course, that time
you have to create time.
Yeah, it will be there.
And I know now the trainer will push you.
The trainer will push you.
Yeah, because they are also sharing your goals as a client. Mm-hmm. So your goal, the trainer will want to share.
Because when you have a personal trainer, that fitness journey, it's personal to the trainer.
Sure. Yeah. So how do you incorporate recovery and rest into your fitness routine?
If you're building muscle, you just have to rest. You don't have any other choice because I usually advise my clients, after you've worked out, rest for some 30 to 40 minutes.
Okay.
If you can manage, and now if you're too busy, don't overwork yourself after workout.
Okay.
You must give your body some time
so that you can rest
with the workout
you've done.
Yeah. Not just you are coming from the workout, you've just worked out some few minutes ago, you are going to do mujengo. No, it doesn't work out.
It doesn't.
If you want to build muscle,
sure.
You rest after workout, you hit your day workout.
Okay.
Take a rest. 30 to 45 minutes.
Rest before you proceed with the workout.
If you are losing weight,
okay.
Most people who are losing weight, they usually say they don't have time.
Okay.
If you are losing weight, it's okay. And finish working out and don't go do your normal duties because you are losing weight. Losing weight, you are punishing your body.
You punish your body.
If you want to gain weight and muscle, you must rest.
You must rest.
Yeah. There's no other way that you'll say, I'm too busy when I'm coming out of the gym, I just want to go to work.
Yeah.
No.
So we have to create, we have to create time to rest.
It's a matter of creating.
Then there's active rest. You can do the active rest and all that.
Okay, rest is not it's not really going to sleep, that is the rest, no.
Okay.
You can just close your eyes and meditate for 30 seconds.
Okay.
That is rest.
That is rest enough.
Active rest.
Yeah.
You can just walk, give stories to your friends. Yeah, don't do something heavy to your body after workout.
Yeah, that's why we recommend a client can work out like 4 times a week.
Yes.
So you saw the remaining 3 days. No, that we can count them as rest days. Maybe you can just go for a walk or go swimming. You do the active the active rest. You see, because also the body, you know, the body needs to rest. Because for example, you know, once if you overwork your body, you know, there are these stress hormones in the body like cortisol hormone. This hormone, you see, mostly is produced when the body is stressed. You know, fitness, a physical stress. So workout is a physical stress. So when the body is stressed much, you are not getting the enough amino or branched chain amino acids. So you find the body is producing a lot of cortisol, and the cortisol is counterproductive. So instead of getting the results that you want, you work, but now cortisol will, if you are losing weight, cortisol will ensure that you store fat in your body. How do you find the right balance between cardio training and strength training in your fitness routine?
Both workouts are very important first.
Okay.
Whether you are building muscle, you want to shed fat.
Okay.
The two exercises are very important.
Yeah, both cardio and strength training. Okay.
So when you are building muscle,
yes,
you will train for some time. Like for example, when you start training as you're going to build muscle,
yeah,
you'll do more, you'll concentrate on building the muscle
first.
Most
okay.
people forget, you build muscle, you become so stiff,
okay,
that you cannot do some
of the moves, and
you realize you cannot even sprint.
You are not there, you can't sprint
20 meters only.
Okay, yeah, sure,
because you are not involving cardio. Is very important, whether you are building muscle or
you're cutting and all that
weight. Yeah. So what I usually advise my clients is to do, if you're building muscle, supposed to do a warm up, at least a warm up.
Yeah.
Just warm up a cardio for 3 minutes.
Okay.
Then you do your weight. After finishing your weight, your body is stiff.
Yeah, sure.
Yeah. You have to do a bit cardio, just 2 minutes cardio, not that intense cardio that will make you lose your gains.
Okay.
Just a few kind of stretches. Stretches are also cardio.
Yeah, stretch is part of cardio. Yeah, we have active stretches and all. Exactly. Yeah.
For a person who is losing weight.
Okay.
You're supposed to do mostly of intensity of cardio.
Yeah, so you focus first.
You focus on cardio. Yeah, intense.
When I still have like enough energy. So I just come to the gym, I do enough cardio. Uh-huh. Then thereafter now is
after
when
cardio, now the trainer will program for you.
For strength training.
Strength training. Of course, both of them are very important. Both of them, in fact, whether you are building muscle
or you are cutting, you have to do both cardio and strength.
Yeah, because you usually get some clients, I don't want to grow muscle.
Muscles.
No, you cannot grow muscle.
It's not easy.
It's not easy to grow muscle. Most people
I've seen people say, no, I don't want to be bigger like this, so and so. It takes time. People are really struggling for 10 years. Mm-hmm. You know, they getting enough proteins for them to just gain those muscles. I think it's enough, because for cardio, cardio is going to work on your cardiovascular, you know, the heart and the lungs at the same time. You know, cardio will make sure that your vessels are okay, your breathing system is okay, you have a strong core and all that. Then for strength training, you know, maybe you want to gain some muscles, specific regions, whether bicep, chest, and all the full body. Yeah, I think that's fair enough. So what I'm getting from you, that you have to balance. I've seen those patients want to lose weight. Now, even if you want to lose, what we want to lose is fat, mostly. Mm-hmm. Not really losing weight, we want to lose fat. So for you to lose fat, you know, if you compare the fat and the muscles, so you see the rate of metabolism. No, muscles, they burn more calories. Muscles burn more calories compared to the fat. So the more muscles you gain, you are able to burn more calories. Yeah. What are some of the ridiculous myths you have heard about fitness?
One of the ridiculous myths, let me talk about supplements. There are those people who come to the gym who don't know more about supplements. But at least for now, people understand supplements is not steroids.
Okay.
Yeah. Everyone thinks supplement is steroids. Supplements, they call it medicines. But supplement is just food.
Okay.
It is food that has been protein. We have different supplements.
Yeah.
Supplements for building mass.
Yeah.
Then we have pure proteins. Then we have those supplements for pre-workout before you train.
Yeah, before training and all that.
So let me talk about the mostly proteins.
Okay.
Yeah. Protein supplements can be used by anyone.
Anyone.
Unless the doctor, you have any doctor has an issue with you, something like that.
Okay.
But supplements is safe for everyone. Supplements just concentrated food.
Okay.
Those are especially protein
okay.
that someone are supposed to take.
To
of
take.
Course, you cannot take enough protein.
You're just through eating
food,
the normal
food. Yeah, when you're working out.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, that is true. Because I've seen, you see, this myth of supplements. You see, even in the hospital, some of the patients with muscle wasting syndrome. I've seen patients use creatine, they use whey. But those patients are prescribed by doctors, by
yeah,
their
true, yeah.
Physicians, if they have muscle wasting syndrome. Then you find whey is just a byproduct, you know, of milk, in a milk processing industrial farm. So they have this product of whey.
Yes.
So now they concentrate whey and become the, so it's a natural thing,
it's a natural
really.
Thing.
Things like creatine is a natural, whey is natural. This pre-workout we are doing is just caffeinated, they have high caffeine.
Yes.
Content, so really, so there's a very big difference between the steroids and
yeah,
the,
yes,
the steroids falls under illegal substances.
Yes.
Yeah, so there are very big difference between the steroids and the normal
mm-hmm.
supplement. That is true.
So yeah. I just want to advise anyone watching this,
yeah,
supplement is very safe.
Yeah, it's very safe.
Very safe. Sure. And you just talk to your trainer, he advise you which supplement you need.
You want to use,
yeah.
So that you don't just come from home, it's your first day of training,
yeah.
You want to do pre-workout, you want to do creatine,
no,
you
no,
want
no,
to
no,
weigh.
No, you
so you have to consult, at least you have some guidance
yeah.
from your personal coach, because they have enough information on some of these supplements.
Mm-hmm.
So you have to work out for some time. They will do assessment after 2 to 3 months, then they can advise you on which supplements to use. Thank you so much. Coach, for coming.
Thank you to Coach Wakesa.
Okay. Thank you so much, guys, for tuning in. That was our fitness podcast. We have shared different aspects. We have discussed different questions. So the information, you can get it on our social platforms. You can like, comment, and you can share with your friends. Let's get the engagement going. Let's continue engaging till we meet again. See you.